name is Dr. Lee Lindquist, and I'm Division Chief of Geriatrics here at Northwestern Medicine.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jeanette Cheng, and I am currently a geriatric fellow at Northwestern Medicine.
So I hear so much about these urinary tract infections, or UTIs, causing confusion in older adults. And we actually know that confusion alone does not mean a person is having a urinary tract infection. There's a lot more other symptoms older adults need to have in order to be considered a UTI.
And some of these symptoms include fever, chills, suprapubic pain, and sometimes gross hematuria. And we overly diagnose asymptomatic bacteriuria because of these unnecessary tests for something that is actually not a urinary tract infection. And that leads to overuse of antibiotics, leading to antibiotic resistance and just a sequelae of events that make it worse for the patient and for the family members.
Yeah, one of those dangerous sequelae is Clostridium difficile, which is C. diff, where people have a lot of diarrhea after they are prescribed an antibiotic. And this happens a lot when older adults are unnecessarily prescribed antibiotics for a perceived UTI, because then we see older adults getting a lot of diarrhea, getting very dehydrated, and it carries a high mortality. There's some studies that have shown about 1 in 2 adults that are over the age of 80 who get C. diff actually have died. So this is dangerous. So we actually prefer, if you suspect that the person has confusion with one of those ancillary symptoms like fevers, chills, suprapubic pain, to actually get the urinalysis, but then wait a couple days for the urine culture to come back.
So usually from a urinalysis, we wait a few days until there's a positive urine culture with over 100,000 colonies. The urinalysis sometimes do not signify a true infection because they have something called contamination, and that's during the sample collection where it's contaminated by skin flora. And that doesn't really necessarily mean that there is a urinary tract infection. It just means that the collection of the sample is contaminated, and we shouldn't treat patients with antibiotics with that negative UA.
It's imperative that we wait for a urine culture result to come back. And I've had so many family members and patients and, you know, different nurses or providers say, well, those 3 days, you know, what happens if they get worse? What happens if they get septic? And there's research out there that shows waiting 3 days or waiting 2 days until the culture results makes no difference, but it actually is beneficial to wait to make sure that you've got the right antibiotics for the right patient. So it doesn't harm the patient by waiting a couple days.